हेलो एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ मधुमिता, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर सौंदर्या इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एंड साइंस. इन टुडेज लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ डीएफए फ्रॉम गिवन एनएफए यूजिंग लेजी इवैल्यूएशन मेथड. सो व्हेन एंड दिस टॉपिक विल बी हेल्पफुल फॉर ऑल बीसीए एमसीए एज वेल एज इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट्स टू. In this problem, and in graphical representation of NFA will be provided to us. We'll see all five tuples of NFA. That is, Qn is my number of state. That is Q0, Q1, Q2, and then summation. That is 0 and 1, which all inputs are provided for this NFA. Transition symbol. This is my transition by getting at Q0, by getting 0, where it will travel or it will move. That is, at Q0 it will transit to Q0 or Q1, anywhere it can move. If I am at Q0, by getting 1 as an input, I'll be at Q0 only. Same way, if we are at Q1, by getting 0, nowhere will go, so it is 5. So, and then at Q0, if I am having 1 as an input, will move to Q2. Same way, for Q2, if I am at Q2, but we don't have here any input, so we have given 5. So, that means nowhere it will move. Q0 means this is the star symbol. Star symbol, we know, with this arrow, it indicates that Q0 is my star symbol. Fn is my final state for NFA. We can see here concentric circle or double circle that indicates my final state. That is, Q2 is my final state. This is my given problem in form of NFA. Now we have to convert it into DFA. To convert it into DFA, our first step is we have to always start from start symbol, that is start state. Q0 is my start state. We'll consider start state. Over start state, we'll apply both the input. After applying both the inputs, we'll check where it will transit. If the resultant transit is my new state, if I get any new state, will perform the same for that particular state also. That means over that state also we'll apply both the inputs. Here we have 0 and 1 as an input, so both the input will apply over that new state. We'll continue till we get any further, we are not getting any further new state. As soon as we'll get all old state, we'll stop this process and we'll construct DFA. So, if you have any confusion, when we'll solve this problem, it will be more clear to you. Let us start. Here we have our start state, that is Q0 is my start state. Over start state will perform with first 0 as an input. That is 0 as an input. Q0, 0. That means I am at Q0. By applying 0 over Q0, where I'll transit, by seeing this table, it will be clear to us. That is, it will move to Q0 and Q1. So it is Q0 to Q1. This is my resultant. After applying 0 on my Q0, a resultant state we got, that is Q0 and Q1. When we have applied 0, second input we have, that is 1, we have to apply 1 also over this. So over Q0, if we apply 1, where it will transit, we'll check in table again, it will transit to Q1 only. So, my resultant state, what all we have got after completion of my first step, that is Q0, Q1 and Q1. So, in this two, Q1 already we have operated right now. So, it is old state. This is my new state, what we have got. over this again we'll apply the same. So over this we'll apply we have got from by applying over Q0 both the input we got our state, that is Q0, Q1 and Q0. Since we have got Q0 already, we have applied on Q0, so we'll consider this as my old state. Q0, Q1 will consider it as new state. Okay, then over new state again we have to apply both the inputs, that is 0 and 1 will apply both the inputs over Q0, Q1. Then using extended transition function, we'll solve this. Q0, comma over input 0, then union, this is only your extended transition function, N Q1 0. So we'll check what is our resultant state we'll get from this Q0 0. You can see here over Q0 0 we'll get, that is Q0 Q1 will get. Union Q1 0, Q1 0, it is null, nothing. So my resultant state is Q0 Q1. After applying 0 over Q0, Q1, we got our resultant state, that is Q0, Q1. Same way, we'll apply 1 also over this. So, that is N Q0 input 1, N Q1, 1. So, this is my extended transition function, that is Q0, 1. By applying Q0, over Q0 1, what will get, that is Q0 will get, Q0 will get. Union Q1 1, Q1 1 will get Q2. So that is Q2. If we do union of this two state, it is Q0 Q2. So this is my resultant state what we got after applying 0 and 1, that is Q0, Q1, which is my old state, and another state we got, that is Q0, Q2. This is my new state. Again, we'll apply the same over this new state also. 0 and 1 will apply over Q0, Q2 also. Till we'll not get all this old state, we have to keep on doing the same. So that is extended transition function Q0, 0, union transition function Q2, 0. That is over Q0, 0, Q2, 0 we have applied. We'll check what is my resultant state we'll get over Q0, 0, over Q0, 0 if we apply, that is my Q0, Q1 we got. Union Q2 0 is Q2 over 0, that is null. So my resultant after applying 0 will get Q0 Q1. After applying over Q0 Q2, resultant we got, that is Q0 Q1. Same way we'll apply 1 also. Transition function 0 1 1 union transition function Q2 1. So we'll check our resultant state what we'll get over Q0 after applying 1, over Q0 by applying 1 we'll get Q0. Then over Q2 applying 1 we'll get null. So my resultant is Q0. So you can check over Q0, Q2 will get 0, Q0, Q1 after applying 0, and another one Q0 will get after applying 1. So we can observe that this Q0, Q1 as well as Q0 both are my old state. So we'll stop performing here. Then we'll design transition table. What all state we got what all new states we got, those will be considered as states of my DFA, and its transition table will draw. How to draw, we'll see. Which all states we got at Q0? First state, this was my start state, so it is my start state Q0 here also. Over Q0 we have two input, that is 0 and 1. Over Q0, by applying 0, we can see where we have moved, it is Q0. So it is here Q0. Same way, no, resultant is Q0, Q1, Q0, Q1. Okay, then over Q0 by applying 1, it is Q0. It is Q0. Okay, first state we have covered, that was my start state. Next state we covered, new state we got, that is Q0, Q1. Q1. So by applying 0, my resultant state we got, that is Q0, Q1. Over Q0, Q1, by applying 1, our resultant state we got, that is Q0, Q2. Then new state again we have, that is Q0, Q2. This is my new state, Q0, Q2 is my new state. Over this state, after applying 0, we got our resultant, that is Q0, Q1. Over Q0, Q2, by applying 1, we got our resultant state, that is Q0. So now all state we have covered. Now we have to check which one among these three, which one will be my final state. So this was my last state over what we have performed. So this is my, and we have even Q2 also. So this state will be considered as my final state. By seeing this table, now we'll draw its graphical representation of DFA. So we have first state, that is Q0. This is my start state. Then second state we have, that is Q0, Q1. Third state we have Q0, Q0, Q2. This is my final state also. So now we'll perform the link. So from Q0, by applying 0, we'll move to Q0, Q1. This is by applying 0, we'll move to Q0, Q1. Then if I'm at Q0, by applying 1, we'll transit to Q0. That means self loop. Then if I'm at Q0, Q1, this state, by applying 0, I'll be at the same state, that is self loop. It is by applying 0, will be on the same state. If I am at Q0, Q1, by applying 1, I'll move to Q0, Q2. So I am at Q0, Q1, by applying 1, I'll move to Q0, Q2. Then third state, that is Q0, Q2. If I am at Q0, Q2, by applying 0, I'll move to Q0, Q1. So I'll move to Q0, Q1. Then if I am at Q0, Q2, Q0, Q2, by applying 1, I'll move to Q0. So like this, we'll move to Q0. Even this is your resultant graphical representation of your DFA. What we have converted, the given NFA is now converted to its equivalent DFA. Even you can, if you feel that these states are a bit complicated or confusing, you can rename also. You can rename it. You can rename this Q0 with A, B, and C, and you can perform. This is all about your conversion of your DFA from your NFA using lazy evaluation method. I hope this lecture will be clear to you. Thank you.